pride himself in being a good judge of books. I don't pretend to know very much about this.
I insist upon being locked down now. I've been trying to lock down.
quite what I was thinking earlier tonight when I was looking at the leftovers of David Smith.
I think I'd like to look at that.
Dr. Brown, all the time.
I don't see why.
I told you before, one line of inquiry and one person at a time. Otherwise, we'll all be talking at one. You might have to turn out soon.
Getting a bit heavy-handed.
I'm responsible.
And if she doesn't find out why this had to happen to the girl, she'll be regretting it every day, the next day, throughout the next night.
Yes. Yes, that's right. I know I'm to blame, and I'm desperately sorry. But I can't, I won't believe that it was simply my fault, that in the end she simply committed suicide. That would be too horrible.
Yes. You see, we have to share something. If there's nothing else, we have to share our feelings.
Yes, that's true. I don't understand about you.
There's no reason why you should.
I haven't met many police inspectors, but the ones I have met aren't a bit like you.
Good evening, Inspector.
Good evening, Madam. Yes, we often do on the young ones. They're more impressionable.
It's no use, Gerald. You're wasting time.
And it was quite obvious once I
tell them.
I
coming back, if I may.
Well, Chris, I don't know. I hope we come again in this pretty business.
I like to consider you better.
Well, Chris, I don't know.
You know, Inspector, you never showed him a picture of that girl.
No, I thought it better not.
You have a photograph of this girl?
Yes, and perhaps you should have a look at it.
I don't see why I should.
Oh, no. But we should have a look at it.
Very well.
Do you remember her?
No, I don't.
Well, of course she may have changed lately, but I don't think she could have changed that much.
All right, thank you.
You're not telling me the truth.
Look here, I'll not have this. You'll apologize at once. Apologize for what? Doing my duty.
No, for being so offensive about it. I'm a public man.
Public men, Mr. Burley, have their privileges as well as their responsibilities.
Possibly. But you wouldn't have to come here to talk to me about my responsibilities.
That's what we did.
Well, it means that we've no reason now to put on silly airs. And if we've any sense, we won't try. And I know jolly well that you did in fact recognize that girl from the photograph and the way that you looked. I don't know why you should pretend not to, but if you're not telling the truth, why shouldn't the inspector apologize?
The girl must have come back.
Unless your son has just gone out.
Oh, see.
Mrs. Burley, you're a prominent member of the Rumbling Women's Charitable Organization, aren't you?
Yes. We've done some very useful service for deserving cases.
It's an organization to which women in distress can appeal in various forms, if that's so.
Yes.
There was a meeting with the interviewing committee 2 weeks ago.
You just had to go to bed with her, did you?
Well, I'm old enough to be married, aren't I?
And I'm not.
And I hate these fat old tops going around town.
Some of which are yours.
I don't want any of that sort of talk from you. I don't want it from either of you. Go on.
Well.
Get over with it. And Eric, you just
I do take an interest in it. Too much, that's not true.
It's not true.
Have they?
That's just what I'm saying, Eric.
Yes, but you don't seem to understand. From that chap was, the fact remains that I did what I did. Mother did what she did, and you all did what you did to her. It's the same as one story, but it was told to the police inspector or somebody else. According to you, I feel a lot better about it. I'm sorry, my dear, but they're so damned exasperating. They won't try and see the difference between them. Like this coming out in private and a downright public scandal.
And I say the girl's dead, and we know how to kill her.
And I say the stop shouting will get out.
Yes.
You know, a lot of fathers I know have thrown you out on the street already, so hold your tongue if you want to stay here.
Well, I don't give a damn whether I stay here or not.
Stay here long enough to provide me with an account of all the money you stole.
Very heartily working on bits of information, Mr. McGuffey. Love solved the thing we did that was going by somehow.
And so we have. But how do you know it's the same girl?
Now, wait a minute. Let's see how that would work.
No, it wouldn't.
Yes, but we've all admitted it.
All right. We've all got something to do with
a girl.
But how do you know it's the same girl? Look at this girl. You sound girl all these things, yes? Have you forgotten that?
Yes, that part's straightforward enough.
But you also happen to know that Sheila had a girl sat in the old shop, shows her a photograph of her, and says it's the same girl.
Yes, the same photograph.
How do you know it's the same photograph? You sworn your father with that?
No, I didn't.
And did you sworn your daughter with that?
Did you mention it? I did not.
See, the moment showing different photographs, you never remember.
Now, me.
I never saw a photograph. He called me out so if I second girl changed the name to Daisy Brenton. I gave myself away once because I know that Daisy Brenton.
And you have absolutely no proof that this Daisy Brenton really wasn't even scared to second.
Now, what happened after I left?
I was so upset because this man had said he very didn't come back. He had to go out on that night. And he was so assertive and rude that made me more upset still. Then suddenly, he said, I see what you said 2 weeks ago.
Those were his exact words.
Yes, madam, but don't forget, he also showed you a photograph.
Did anybody else see that photograph?
No, of course not. I also would have said so. But I feel so worried when he suddenly turned on me. I left my answer that he wanted.
Yes, and I don't see now why you did that. She didn't call herself Amos Smith when she came to see you in the service, did she?
No.
Anybody else, they called you, see that photograph?
No. She showed it only to me.
How did you
feel? She showed the photograph.
No, but you didn't need one by the time you got out to me. You were alive there.
Why was that insane girl?
Well, because she came to her, because she went to Amy's little money, and you know, I had already told you that.
Well, maybe they're not going to pay her. They're all made in a load of nonsense.
I don't see it's a load of nonsense when a girl doesn't kill herself. I can't get myself out of this mess. They not any mother. You did it all right. Don't be in a hurry to put yourself in the court. That poor interview with your mother has been just as much as a job as restless. The whole damn thing.
Really now? Now, what do you think is happening?
I don't know anymore.
Only to the point. Like all of your brothers.